Hey guys, what's up? This is Bharat. You're watching iGyan. Now we've spent quite a bit of time with the Xiaomi Mi laptops, and we've got the Horizon Edition here. And we wanted to tell you what our experience has been. So in this review, we're going to go through the paces and also show you what's inside the laptop and tell you what we like and what we dislike. If you guys are interested in checking out the unboxing video, we'll leave a link to that in the description below, or you can click the top right bubble to get to that. Let's quickly get started. Now the Mi Notebook 14 has been launched in two variants. One is the standard Mi Notebook 14. It's available in a silver color, much like what you find on MacBooks. It is also available in a Mi Notebook 14 Horizon Edition, the one that we have here, and that is available in a gray color, much like the space gray that you see on Apple laptops. So they've actually taken a lot of design cues from Apple in this, and there's no denying that. So this one has a completely flat shell over here. And you can see that it's got no logos or designs on the back shell of the top case. And it's completely flat and minimalistic. It's also got this matte finish. Even though it attracts a lot of oils and fingerprints, it still looks cleaner than most glossy laptops would. Especially if you had a plastic covering here, it would be really difficult to keep it clean. But in this scenario, it remains clean most of the time. And even if you need to clean this out, all you need is a simple microfiber cloth. The good thing about this is that because it is aluminum, not only does it look premium, it also feels really great when you're using this laptop. The hinge on the display here as well is also really robust. It's pretty tight and you can keep the display at any angle that you want. They say they tested it for thousands of openings, but in our test we found that it is just the right tightness. It's really easy to move, but it's also very stable wherever you leave it. Now the one big downside that right off the bat I need to talk about is this. Even though this is a pretty decent web camera, it's a 720p web camera that is included inside the box of the Mi Notebook 14 or the 14 Horizon Edition. I'm not a big fan of external webcams, and I would have liked to see an internal webcam because it just makes your life easier because you don't have one extra thing to carry around. Also, the webcam is only 720p and it does not support Windows Hello. So if you want to use your secure login to get into Windows, you won't be able to do that. So big downside on that aspect that you don't have a webcam inbuilt. There is a plus aspect to this as well. A lot of businesses, a lot of companies require you to disable the web camera via software or not have a web camera on your laptop. And in those scenarios, which I think this was built for when they built it in China, this is a pretty good option for somebody who's in that scenario. For somebody who's now working at home, especially in the current environment, if you're at home doing a lot of video conferencing calls, a lot of meetings online, this is not a good option because you always need to have this around and you might misplace it, you might lose it. So those are things that sort of disappoint you. Now the display is a 14-inch display. The form factor is pretty small. So it's a 13-inch form factor if you compare it to any other 13-inch laptop. But actually you get a pretty nice display, which is a 14-inch display. Now there is an anti-glare coating on the display, which means that it is a matte finish display, which is excellent for using in high light environments. Again, designed for the workplace. If you are in a office setup or in a corporate office setup where lighting is more than ample, this is a really good laptop to work in those settings because you have a lot of glare from your external lights, and that is sort of defeated with the anti-glare coating. This also means that your laptop screen will not get a lot of smudges, and it also means that if you are one of those people I hate, that tap on the screen of the laptop all the time to point at things, you will not get fingerprints on this. But what this leads to is that things on the display are not that sharp with an anti-glare coating. And this has been an issue for laptops for a long time. If you do get a laptop with an anti-glare coating, it's not as bright or as vivid as a standard display would be. So that is definitely a downside. It's also not the greatest for things like editing photographs because you can't really see the edges properly if you zoom in all the way. So those kind of things eliminate the need for a matte finished display. But again, if you're in a workspace or if you're somebody who's a casual user, if you're just browsing the web or just using it for document processing, the screen is great for that and will work more or less pretty well. Now, one thing that I constantly felt about the display was the lack of brightness. Now, it's only at 200 nits, which is a very low brightness for a laptop screen, especially if you're somebody who's using it indoors as well as outdoors. If you're somebody who likes to use their laptop in cafes and sitting outside, this is not the best screen for that because the overall brightness is not great. And it also doesn't ramp up in areas where it'll be extremely bright. So if you're looking for something that is extremely bright with respect to the screen, if you're somebody who's using the laptop outdoors a lot, this Mi Notebook will not fit your criteria because of the lack of a bright display. The display is also still a 1920 by 1080p display. So with respect to resolution, it's good. You could have seen a higher resolution, but at this price point, you're not really complaining. Let's move down to the bottom case, which is the keyboard over here. It's a fairly nice keyboard. It's well spaced. The keys have a nice amount of travel. They're chiclet style keys. They do have a butterfly mechanism inside. Overall, good amount of travel, easy to type on, not a lot of feedback from the keys and not a lot of sound either. Again, designed for workspace, so not clicky keys, but comfortable to use, and the rest area around the keyboard also is fairly wide and easy to use. Now, in the unboxing video, we mentioned that this is a glass trackpad, and there was a little bit of a confusion in terms of communication. We assumed that the Ryzen notebook has a glass trackpad, whereas the regular one has a plastic trackpad, but it turns out that both of them have a plastic trackpad. So this one as well is a plastic trackpad, but nonetheless, it behaves like a glass trackpad. It's extremely responsive. You do have multi-touch and gesture control, and it's also got a fair amount of travel and a good amount of click in it. You can also use tap to click on things like you would in Windows. And then also you do have dual-sided clicks, so you can have a left click or a right click assigned to a single trackpad, much again like MacBooks. If you click on the right, it becomes the right click. Pretty well-made trackpad. Despite it being a plastic trackpad, the response time, the way multi-touch gestures work, integration of the trackpad with the operating system has been done properly by Xiaomi. The laptops are available with either a Core i5 or a Core i7. It is a 10210U processor for the Core i5 and a 10510U processor for the Core i7. With the Core i5, you get 1.6 GHz quad core with a boost clock up to 4.2 GHz on turbo, and 1.8 GHz on the Core i7 with turbo up to 4.9 GHz. So as far as processing capabilities, fairly performance-oriented laptops. Again, but not the latest chips from Intel for the Mi Notebook 14. But for the price, again, you can't really complain for the kind of chips you're getting. Also, U is a low power generation, more like for mobile applications. So you get that in the laptop as well. So for graphics, you either get an option of the standard Intel 620 graphics, or you can upgrade to an MX250 in the regular Mi Notebook 14. If you're using the Mi Notebook 14 Ryzen edition, you can upgrade to the MX350. I would recommend that you do upgrade to those graphics if you want to do anything slightly closer to graphic related activities. Even browsing the internet becomes slightly better with a better graphics card. So I would definitely recommend that you pick up the discrete graphics card option, even though it's a little bit extra than the standard price of the laptops. Now, we did manage to pop open the backside of the laptop to see what kind of layout we have on the motherboard. The motherboard is pretty well laid out. You have everything spread out quite well. For thermals, there's a single fan that is connected with the heatsink for the CPU as well as the GPU. The SD RAM is soldered on. It's DDR3 RAM made by Samsung. And we have 8 1-gigabyte chips that are soldered onto the motherboard. So they're not replaceable. You can't add more RAM. And that is a big downside for a lot of people. It's definitely a downside for somebody who's buying a laptop in this price bracket because you don't have the upgradable RAM. We did get the laptop with the NVMe SSD, and in this scenario, you can pop out the NVMe SSD and upgrade it for a larger size. However, you do get a 512 gigabyte NVMe SSD. For most people, that is enough. But if somebody does want that amount of storage, that upgrade possibility is there on the machine. We saw that the thermal compound was also installed appropriately. I feel you could open this up and remove the thermal compound to add some of your own thermal compound to better improve the thermal conductivity between the chips and the heatsink. And we also found that there were heat pads or thermal pads on the VRAM as well. So pretty well made on the inside. Could have seen better thermal performance from this. It does tend to heat up, but we'll talk about that more when we get to the other aspects of this review. Now, when you flip this open to the backside, you'll see that there's a good amount of ventage here for air pass through. And again, the fan sucks in air directly from here. So it's a good place to have a vent. You do have few standoffs here, a bigger standoff on the back. It's a rubberized foot, as well as a smaller standoff on the bottom. Again, a rubberized sort of long foot. A very stable design, and also lifts up the laptop from the floor, giving you sort of a laptop stand effect, allowing the air to pass through without any issues. The speakers are placed on either side. They are stereo speakers. They're quite horrible. You might want to figure out better speakers for this. They're not loud enough even to watch videos. We found that in most cases, the audio seemed very low. And if you're thinking of gaming on this, you'll definitely not enjoy the speakers at all. Now for ports on sides, you do have a combination of three USB ports. So two of them are USB 3.1 ports, whereas the one on the left is a USB 2.0. I guess this is for attaching a mouse or an external keyboard, and USB 2.0 is fine for that. They could have popped in a USB 3.0 at least, but they haven't done that for some reason. Possibly it saves them money, I'm not sure. If you get the Horizon Edition and the flagship variant in that with the Core i7, you do get a USB Type-C, but this is still a 3.1 port. It's not a Thunderbolt port for a lot of people who are confused. This is just a USB Type-3 and it does not have power delivery. So you can't charge the laptop with this. Again, something that I would have liked to see. Especially coming from Xiaomi, especially coming in this price bracket. I've seen Xiaomi laptops in the past and they always used USB Type-C. This one again is targeted more towards business users, and I feel that they prefer a brick laptop. And this one is a brick laptop because it comes with a massive charging brick as well. Now, battery life on this is pretty substantial. You can really go through the entire day without worrying about the battery life on this. The charger is a 65 watt charger. It takes fairly long to charge up the laptop. You'd easily spend about an hour and a half to 2 hours to charge up the machine. But even at that, it's pretty good considering everything that is being used on the machine. Now for performance, if you're using the machine for daily usage, for browsing the internet or even creating documents or document processing, this will really fulfill all your needs, whether you get the basic variant or you get the Horizon Edition. For everyday usage, this is a really good laptop. If you're just watching some videos online, if you're consuming content, if you're just creating some documents, etc., this will really work for your requirements. If it comes to a little bit more performance, you can edit photographs on this. So if you download Photoshop, if you download Illustrator, you can use this laptop for that. I would recommend that you pick up a wireless mouse as well. Xiaomi does sell this 500 rupee wireless mouse. We use it. It's a pretty good wireless mouse. Definitely recommend you to pick this up if you're getting the laptop because it goes well with terms of aesthetic with the machine. But you can pick really any mouse. If you want to splurge a little bit more, you can go pick up a nice Logitech Bluetooth mouse and it'll work well with this. I would recommend that you get a mouse if you're going to be doing anything more than basic usage, because even though the trackpad is good, it's not the biggest trackpad and it's not the most comfortable to use because it's much closer to the edge at the bottom here. So an external mouse, especially if you're going to be using it on a desk, is definitely recommended. Now for gaming, it's a mixed bag completely, because we ran benchmarks and not the best scores for benchmarks on the machine, including on Geekbench, including on Shadow of the Tomb Raider. We were getting only 30 FPS. Even if we set the settings to the lowest, we're only getting 30 FPS from the game, which is not very substantial for gaming. And this is the flagship Mi Notebook 14. So if you're looking to game and pick up the flagship variant, you're still not going to get good performance from this. However, on the flip side, we downloaded the full version of PUBG, and somehow that with good amount of graphics works at around 60 FPS. So it's a mixed bag. So depending on what game I guess you want, you can get different performance for gaming on this machine. If you want to play games like Shadow of the Tomb Raider, maybe they're not well optimized for this CPU-GPU combination, or maybe it's just not well powered for those kind of graphics, whereas things like PUBG, which usually demand a lot more graphics capability, they're working pretty fine on this. So depending on what game you're going to be playing more, this laptop may or may not suit your needs. For performance from the other aspect, the MX350 GPU is pretty well stated in this price bracket. It's one of the first laptops to have that. And in terms of graphics performance, it performs really well for a 50,000 rupee price tag. Overall, the Xiaomi Mi Notebook is a pretty good laptop. You get really good battery life from this. You get a decent build quality with a metal aluminum frame and a chassis that is completely made out of aluminum. You have a really nice keyboard, which does have a nice travel as well as well spaced out keys and good and easy to use keyboard layout. And you have a decent display with an anti-glare coating. You're missing a web camera. The overall design is really nice and muted, very minimalistic, no branding whatsoever except for this small Mi branding on the bottom of the LCD. But there are lots of downsides as well. I would like to see a proper web camera. I would like to see a backlit keyboard. We don't have a backlit keyboard here. I would like to see a slightly better trackpad, even though this one is pretty good for what it's useful for. And I would like to see better ports on the side of the machine. Also, you do have this turbo mode, which allows you to ramp up the fans and ramp up the GPU, CPU so that you can get better performance. But even with that turned on, we're not seeing a big difference with respect to performance on the machine. It does ramp up the fans. It will give you better thermal performance if you're doing something for longer periods of time, like extended gaming. It is recommended that you put it on turbo mode so that you do get better thermals and your CPU and your GPU lasts much longer. But overall, it's not adding a lot more performance to the machine. It's just giving it better airflow. So with respect to that, it's a great machine if you're looking at things like that. But with respect to a lot of downsides, it's not giving me the kind of graphics performance that I would want. It's also not giving me the kind of satisfaction from the display that I would want. But maybe I'm expecting a lot. And considering the price, you're still getting a pretty good overall feature set. So you can decide whether or not this fits your requirement, and they are available in a few options, and you can go check them out on Xiaomi's website. But overall, it's a pretty compact form factor, and it's also fairly lightweight for the machine that it is. That's our review. If you liked it, don't forget to smash the like button. Hit the subscribe button if you're not already a part of Team iGAM. This has been Bharat Nagpal. Thank you guys for watching. I'll see you in the next one.